Hello students, welcome back. In this video, I am going to cover the first chapter of class 2, that is computer and electronic device. Okay students, so in this chapter we will see what is a computer. Okay, what are the different tasks that a computer and how it works. Okay, so first of all let us see what is a computer. So first of all we will define the term computer. So students, a computer is an electronic device, okay, that performs several tasks. Okay, so students, how we can define the term computer? So we can define a computer is an electronic device. Okay, so basically computer runs with the help of electricity. It requires electricity in order to run. So it is an electronic device that performs several tasks. So computer performs several tasks for us. Okay, so what are the several tasks? What are the things that a computer performs? So basically there are multiple tasks which computer performs. So if we see the task that computer performs, we can see like this. It helps to draw picture. With the help of computer we can draw the picture. Okay, also you can get the display of different picture. Okay, so it display different pictures . Third one is it plays music and videos. Okay, so for us computer also plays music and videos. If we talk the next thing, it helps us to write letter, okay, email, and also helps to it helps to send all these to other person. Okay, so you can see computer help us to write the letter, okay, an email, and those things can be sent to our friends, relatives, okay, to whom ever we want to send it out. Also there are couple of more things that a computer does for us, like calculations. So with the help of computer you can perform different calculations. Also you can prepare the results. Okay, so students, results can also be prepared with the help of computer. Okay, with the help of computer we can also prepare the bills. Okay, we can store our data. Okay, so there are lots of things apart from all these examples which I have given over here. Apart from all these different tasks, computer also perform a lots of other tasks too. So just like here, you can draw the picture, you can see the different pictures in the computer, you can play music, videos, okay, prepare results, calculations, okay, and also you can surf the net, okay, you can do the net surfing also in the computer. So there are lots of tasks that computer perform. Now the next question arises is how it works. Okay, so we'll see how the computer works. Okay, so before looking to the how computer works, we will see some small examples and we'll understand the working functionality. Okay, so let us see few examples before understanding the working of computer. Suppose we do have bread, okay, and we processed it through the toaster machine. Suppose we have toaster machine, okay, so we have bread, we kept that in a toaster machine, we turned it on, so finally what we are getting? Toasted bread. Okay, similarly suppose we have milk, okay, and we kept this in a refrigerator, okay, and after this sometime it becomes ready and we got ice cream. Okay, so students, from these two examples let us understand what is happening. So you can see we are having some sort of resources or materials, okay, that is bread. We have bread, we are keeping it in a toaster machine, okay, we are turning it on, and after some time we are getting the some different result. Okay, so similarly we do have milk, we kept them in refrigerator, and finally we got the new product, that is a ice cream. So you can see here we are having some things, we are processing, we are doing some work upon that, and we are getting the final output. So in the similar way we'll see the working of computer, like how it works. So first of all, what we used to do, we used to give the input. So we'll be giving some input, finally that input will be processed and at the end we will get the result, okay, or you can say output. So you can see students, basically the computer works like this. We provide some input, okay, and that input is further processed and finally we get the output, that is the result. Now let us understand this with an example. Suppose we have two numbers, that is 2 and another number is 4. So basically we do have these two different numbers and we want to perform the addition over these two numbers. So suppose in an input
we are giving 2 and 4. So these are the two numbers we are giving. What we want to do? And these two numbers are processed further. Okay. So we want to add these two numbers. Fine. So here we are processing. In the processing part, what we are doing? We are adding these two numbers. Finally, after processing, we will get some output, and that output is processed further and displayed, and finally we get the result as a 6 as an output. Okay, so in this way, here it is, we are providing some input, we are getting processed result, we are processing the result, and finally we are getting the output. So this complete whole working cycle, okay, this complete whole working cycle of a computer is known as IPO cycle. IPO
cycle. Okay, so IPO means input, process and output. So in this way basically a computer works. Okay, so I hope you might have a good idea like how the computer works. Okay, so students, in this video we had learned what is computer, what are the different tasks that a computer performs, and also we had covered the working of computer, how the computer works. Okay, so I hope in this video you have got complete idea about all these the topics that we have covered. So students, if you have any confusion or any doubt in any point, okay, so you can mention in the comment box, I will clear out your doubt. So this is all about this video. Hope you have liked it and you enjoyed it. We will meet in the next video with lots of different new concepts. Thank you.